Okay, this is an interesting and challenging one. What's going on here? We have a 10 volt battery connected by a switch. The current has to go through this resistor, but then there is a node here where some of it goes this way, some of it goes this way, and then there's another node here where the current is combined. But it says the switch is closed for a very long time, allowing the capacitor to charge fully. Remember that if the capacitor charges fully, what that means is that the capacitor becomes like a block to the current. No more current can flow through there anymore. So when fully charged, here's what the current looks like. The current is a 10 volt battery, and then it goes across here, and there's 22 kiloohms, and then it goes down here, and then it goes down here, and then it goes through here, and then it goes here, and it goes up here, and this is 57 kiloohms. And what about branch? Well, this branch doesn't matter because it's like an open switch. Nothing can go through there anymore when it's fully charged. Why is this interesting? Because when it's fully charged and there's no current going down here, that doesn't change the fact that from this node to this node, you can travel past this resistor or you can travel past this capacitor, which means the change in potential from this node to this node has to be the same whether you're looking at this resistor or this capacitor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at this time in the long future where this capacitor is fully charged. There's no current coming down here. And I'm going to find out what voltage it has gotten to, because it can't be at 10 volts because there's a voltage drop here. So up 10 volts, down something, and down something else when you do a Kirchhoff loop all the way around here. So this cannot charge to 10 volts. It's going to charge to something less. And the way I'm going to find that out is by finding out what the potential difference is between this node and this node. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply V equals IR to the whole system here. And what I get is 10 equals I times 22 plus 57 times 10 to the 3. I feel like I must have this written down somewhere. Yes, I do. So I'm not starting from scratch. And so from that, I find out that I is equal to 1.266 times 10 to the negative 4 amps. That's how much current is flowing through there. But what I wanted to do was I wanted to focus on the 57 coulomb resistor. Kiloohm resistor. Once again, we can use V equals IR. And we know that the current going through there is 1.266 times 10 to the negative 4. And we know that its resistance is 57 times 10 to the 3. So from that, we can find out the voltage of that, which is 7.215 volts. This is the voltage of the capacitor. Remember, if it's 7.215 volts from here to here, because that's how far it is as you go across the 57 coulomb resistor, it has to be the same if you go this route. From one place to another has to be the same difference in height, no matter which path you take to get from one of those places to the other. So what we're going to do is we're now going to say, the voltage of the capacitor is like that, but now it discharges. Because we've opened the circuit. So if we open this circuit here, so current is no longer flowing this way, this circuit, so wait a minute, this capacitor now has charges. What happens to these charges? These charges, they're not going to go up there because there's nowhere to go, so they're going to go like this. So now you have this nice simple circuit that looks like this. You have a capacitor and you have a resistor. That's it. You have this capacitor of 18 microfarads and you have this resistor of 57 kiloohms and you have a V0 on the capacitor, which is 7.215 volts. So the question says, how long does it take for the voltage of the capacitor to drop to 1 volt? Well, this is discharging because the capacitor was charging it and now it's discharging. So we can use that idea that Q of T when you're discharging is Q naught E to the negative T over tau, except that I want to use the voltage version of it. V equals V naught E to the negative T over tau. So we want the voltage to be 1. And we know that the voltage at the beginning is 7.215 E to the negative T over tau. Hey, I didn't find tau. I better find tau for this circuit. Tau equals RC equals 57 times 10 to the 3 times 18 times 10 to the negative 6. And from that, I get 1.026 seconds. So T divided by 1.026. I think I'll divide both sides by 7.215 and I get 0.1386 equals e to the negative t over 1.026. Get rid of the exponential function on this side by taking ln of both sides. So I'm going to take the ln of 0.1386 and I get negative 1.976 equals negative t over 1.026. So t equals 2.03 seconds. And that seems to be what I have there. And so that finishes part 2 on circuits and capacitors.